Is this quickie wrong or wrong? There are things that are wrong, and there are things that are really wrong. A lot of times in a debate, both sides might get called out, and people will say, well, they're equal then. An example might be a creationist pointing out a scientific theory that was just proven wrong, or a statist might point to a prediction of an Austrian economist that didn't quite pan out. But not all wrongs are equally wrong. Science fiction legend Isaac Asimov wrote a series of essays about the relativity of wrong. Yes, every century proves the previous century wrong about something, even fundamental things like the nature of the universe. But that doesn't mean all modern knowledge is wrong, like some claim. He gave a very good example. When people thought the Earth was flat, they were wrong. When people thought the Earth was spherical, they were wrong. But if you think that thinking the Earth is spherical is just as wrong as thinking the Earth is flat, then your view is wronger than both of them put together. If you model the Earth as a perfect sphere, you'll be off by about 0.3%. If you model it as a flat surface, you'll be wrong on a fundamental level. Now, in certain cases, you can get away with a flat model. If you're navigating around your city, you can use a flat paper map, because on that scale, it doesn't really deviate all that much. But trying to make a global map has been one of history's biggest challenges, with map projections that make Alaska and Greenland appear huge, or squashed, or whatever. Because on that scale, it matters a lot. And if you keep going in one direction, you'll end up back where you started. A spherical globe will show you that. A flat map won't. In fact, the spherical globe will work best for almost any application. It's only if you need enough accuracy that the equatorial bulge matters that you'll need to deviate from the spherical model. One thing we're hearing now is that the Earth is actually pear-shaped because of the difference in the bulge in the southern hemisphere compared to northern. A lot of kooks have made a big deal about this, but the amounts we're talking about are 0.01%ths of a percent. Theories like the spherical Earth get refined. Kook notions like the flat Earth get tossed on the garbage heap where they belong.